हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज शैलजा विभूते. लेट अस कंटिन्यू इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन चैप्टर. टुडे लेट अस लर्न अबाउट एडी करंट्स. फोकॉल्ट ऑब्जर्व्ड दैट व्हेन अ मेटल प्लेट इज मूव्ड इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड और द मेटल प्लेट इज प्लेस्ड इन अ चेंजिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, induced currents produced in the metal plate. Such currents are called eddy currents. These eddy currents flow in circular path and their direction is given by Lenz law. These eddy currents are also called Foucault currents. So what are eddy currents then? These are the currents induced in massive conductors placed in changing magnetic field. Then if we see the applications, or say you can say uses of eddy currents. Eddy currents are used in magnetic braking in trains, used in electromagnetic damping. Eddy currents are used in induction furnace and are used in electric power meters. So you can expect a question here, write any two advantages of eddy currents. So any two you can remember and only mention, no explanation, only you have to mention. Eddy currents are used in magnetic braking in trains, electromagnetic damping, induction furnace and electric power meters. So eddy currents are induced currents when massive conductors are placed in changing magnetic field. Okay, now let us see very interesting concept, that is about self induction. Self induction is, it is a phenomena of induction of EMF and hence current in a coil due to the variation of current in the same coil. So EMF is induced, hence current is induced in a coil when there is a variation of current in the same coil. This phenomena is known as self-induction. Now let us see what is this flux linkage. It is the product of a number of turns in the coil and the magnetic flux linked with the coil. Means flux linkage can be written as, it is equal to N into phi. What is N? Number of turns. What is phi? It is magnetic flux. Then how to define self-inductance of a coil? The self-inductance of a coil can be defined as, it is the EMF induced in the coil due to the unit rate of change of current in the same coil. So what is self-inductance? Usually it is denoted by the letter capital L. How to define this self-inductance then? It is EMF induced in the coil due to the unit rate of change of current in the same coil. Now if we want to write expression for this inductance, then whatever now you have given the definition, that only mathematically if we write, it is E is equal to minus L di by dt, where E is EMF induced in the coil, L is self inductance and di by dt is rate of change of current in the coil. Now let us see how to derive expression for self inductance of a solenoid. What is solenoid? A solenoid is nothing but it is a coil having number of turns and it has some length. Now let us take one solenoid. This is the diagram for the solenoid. Draw that one. Then let L be the length of the solenoid. Small L I have taken. Then capital L is inductance of the coil or solenoid. Then this solenoid has N number of turns. Number of turns, I think you can understand it easily. These are number of turns you are observing here. So N is number of turns. Then I be the current in the solenoid. Connect this solenoid to battery, means for the source, then I be the current in the solenoid. Then let us take one more notation here. Let n be the number of turns per unit length of the solenoid. So small n is number of turns per unit length, capital N is number of turns. Okay, now let us see how to get the expression. As we know, this one, flux linkage is directly proportional to current. So flux linkage can be written as n into phi. Okay, n phi is directly proportional to I. Then if you remove the proportionality sign, you have to take is equal to, and one constant you have to write, that is n phi is equal to L I. What is L here? It is self inductance. So now shift the term and you write L is equal to n phi divided by I. But phi is equal to what? Magnetic field into area. It is a flux. So flux is equal to what? Magnetic field into area of the solenoid. So magnetic field, let us denote it as capital B, and area of the solenoid, take it as A. Substitute these two values in above equation. In this you have to substitute. Okay. So what you will get? L is equal to, instead of this phi, you write BA. So N phi means BA divided by L. Now next step is, in case of solenoid, we have an expression, that is magnetic field of a solenoid can be written as B is equal to mu naught N I. Okay, so mu naught N I you have to write. Then this mu naught is permeability of free space. N is a number of turns per length, I is a current. Substitute the value. After substitution, you will get L is equal to N into mu naught N I A divided by I. So now I get cancelled. This I and this I get cancelled. Okay. So after cancelling, you will get mu naught N, capital N, and small n A. But small n is equal to capital N divided by L. So this capital N divided by L, if you substitute instead of this small n, you will get capital L is equal to mu naught N into N A divided by L. Then what you will get? This only, L is equal to mu naught N square A divided by L. So what is expression for self inductance of a solenoid? Mu naught N square A divided by L. If you explain the symbols, mu naught is permeability of free space, N is number of turns, A is area of a solenoid, and L is length of the solenoid. Here little confusion in the terms here. In the video, means in the slide, this is I current, okay, and till here I get cancelled, here it is L. Okay, little confusion, so make it clear, this is L and this is I. Now let us move to next one. So simple one, if the solenoid has a core of relative permeability mu r, what is meaning of this one? For that, say this is solenoid, okay, having number of turns. In this, if we insert the iron core like this, okay, piece of iron, then it has its own permeability, okay, that is represented as mu r. Then if this solenoid has relative permeability, then expression will be L is equal to mu naught mu r n square a divided by L, means you have to include that relative permeability. You can expect such questions for 1 mark. Okay, now let us see another important point, that is about inductor. So what is inductor then? Inductor is nothing but, it is a circuit element which opposes the change in the current flowing through it. Like resistor, capacitor, however we will take, like that it is inductor. It is a circuit element which opposes the change in the current flowing through it. Then circuit symbol of this inductor is, you have to draw coil like, okay. So this is inductor. Now what is the use of this inductor? If we connect it in a circuit, what happens? Let us try to understand. That only we are learning it in the form of energy stored in an inductor. Whenever the current flows through the inductor, the self-inductance opposes growth of the current. Hence, some work has to be done by external agencies in establishing the current. Means when current flows through the inductor, what happens? That coil starts opposing the increase in the value of current. Okay. But we want to supply more current. Then what we have to do? We have to do some work. Work has to be done by the external agencies. Then this work done is stored as potential energy in the form of magnetic field. Okay. Now let us see how to derive the expression for energy stored in an inductor. This is important derivation. Derive an expression for energy stored in an inductor. Diagram is not necessary. Directly we can start the expression. As we know this one, to store that, to get that increase in the value of current, we had some work has to be done. Let dW be the work done in developing the current I in an inductor in time dt. Okay. Then E be the EMF induced in an inductor. Now rate of work done is given by, rate of work done is nothing but it is power only, correct? So power is equal to, in first year we know this expression, power is equal to what? Work done divided by time. Work done we will express it in terms of charge and potential. So Q into V divided by T. But we know this one, charge divided by time is nothing but it is current. Okay, charge divided by time is equal to what? Current I. Okay, that only we have written. So what you will get? V I you will get. Then instead of potential we are taking it as EMF. Okay, so finally what we got? Rate of work done is nothing but power. Power is equal to E I we got. Okay, now dW divided by dt is rate of work done is equal to EI. But E is equal to what? Minus L DI by DT. Then that negative sign is neglected because you are considering only magnitude. Then substitute the value in above equation. What you will get? dW divided by DT is equal to L into DI by DT into I as it is. Okay. Then this can be written as, this dt and dt get cancelled. See, this dt and this dt get cancelled. Denominators are same, cancel it. So what you will get? dW is equal to Li into dI. Then we want total work done in developing the current from 0 to I. So dW is small amount of work done. Then total work done means what we have to do? We have to integrate the equation both sides. So when we take integration, we require limits. So what are the limits now? 0 to I. Integration of dW, how to write? 0 to I dW is equal to integration 0 to I Li dI. But L is constant, self-inductance. So it cannot be integrated. What we have to do? Write it first. Then integration 0 to I dI. Integration of I dI is I square divided by 2. So L you write as it is. Integration of I dI, this is dI, is equal to I square divided by 2. We have to take the limits. So 0 to I. Okay. So here directly we have written W is equal to 1 by 2 Li square. Upper limit is I, lower limit is 0. When you substitute, again you are going to get I square divided by 2. So you can neglect and you can write it directly. W is equal to half Li square. Okay. Then this work done is stored as magnetic potential energy. So you can change the notation and you can write finally U is equal to half Li square. So what is total energy stored? That total energy stored is nothing but it is U is equal to half Li square. U is equal to half Li square. Okay. So what is the energy stored in an inductor then? Half Li square. Most important derivation, try to remember. Now let us learn about mutual induction. So mutual induction is nothing but it is the phenomena of induction of EMF and hence current in the secondary coil due to the variation of current in the primary coil. Means you have to consider now two coils. One is primary, another one is secondary. I hope you are remembering, we have learnt about coil and coil experiment. There we took first coil C1, for that we have connected battery and key to the coil. Then in second coil, only galvanometer was connected. Then when the first coil, in the first coil, when switch is closed, current starts flowing in the first coil, correct? Due to that variation of current, magnetic flux linked with the first coil induces current in the second coil. So galvanometer in the second coil starts showing the deflection. This we have already learnt in coil and coil experiment. Same concept is nothing but it is mutual induction. Instead of calling first coil and second coil, here it is taken as primary and secondary. Okay, so variation in primary coil induces EMF and current in the secondary coil. This phenomena is called mutual induction. Then mutual inductance, for that how to get the expression? Let phi be the magnetic flux linked with the secondary coil due to flow of current I in the primary coil. Then always flux linked with the secondary is directly proportional to current in the primary. If you remove the proportionality sign, you will get phi is equal to MI. M is proportionality constant and it is called mutual inductance between pair of coils. Then in expression for induced EMF, if you take, it is E is equal to minus M di by dt. Based on this, you can define mutual inductance between pair of coils is numerically equal to the EMF induced in one coil when current is changed at the rate of 1 ampere per second in the neighboring coil. Just observe this so that you can understand how it is changing. This is primary, for that power is connected, current is flowing, then flux is linked with the first coil. Now it is varying, now it is changing. In that changing magnetic flux, if we bring one more coil, see that one. Then in the second coil, EMF and current induces. So this is phenomena of mutual inductance. Okay, SI unit of this mutual inductance is Henry. Then mutual inductance is said to be 1 Henry if 1 volt of EMF is induced in one coil when the current is changed at the rate of 1 ampere per second in the neighboring coil. Okay. So this is definition of 1 Henry. Then here a derivation is not there, directly we have to write the expression for mutual inductance of two long coaxial solenoids having the same length. Expression is M is equal to mu naught N1 N2 A divided by L, where M is mutual inductance, mu naught is permeability of free space, N1 is number of turns of primary, N2 is number of turns in secondary, A is area of the coil, L is length. Okay. If the solenoid has a core of relative permeability, mu r, include that mu r, so that your expression is M is equal to mu naught mu r N1 N2 A divided by L. Okay. Let us continue. Thank you.